So welcome to another class, and let us discuss another problem from our JeeMain 2019 phase 1. If you are wondering why I am repeatedly doing some JeeMain problem, because this year JeeMain question was little difficult and there was lots of conceptual thing, and I think it will be a good practice for you guys. So that's why I am currently just uploading the JeeMain solutions, and I think it will be very good for you because these problems are conceptually superior to some other medium type problem. So let us discuss another problem. So the problem states that 4 equal point charges Q each place in XY plane. This is our X and Y, this is Z direction. So in XY plane, 4 equal point charges capital Q each placed in XY plane at 0, 2, 4, 2, 4, minus 2 and 0, minus 2. The work required to put a fifth charge Q at the origin of the coordinate system will be. So we need to calculate the work done to bring another fifth charge from infinity to here, that is our origin 0, 0. So we have to calculate. So there is 4 charge given in this specific 4 coordinates in the XY plane. So we have, what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the work done to bring another capital Q charge to this 0, 0 point, which is our origin. So how we will do this kind of problem? So if you remember that what is our potential? So let us discuss what the potential is. Say Vr, say there is only one charge Q1, and from that charge at r distance, if we say that Vr is Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r. So for this, only for this Q1 charge at a distance r, our potential is Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r. So what does it mean that at this point the potential is Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r? It means that to bring a unit positive charge from infinity, when r is equal to infinity, why infinity? As you, if you remember that at infinity we say that our potential is 0. So for our electrostatic calculation, basic calculations, we assume that at infinity our potential is 0. So potential for Q1 is Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r at a distance r from this Q1 charge. So what does it mean? It means that if you bring unit positive charge from infinity to this point, external work done required is this much. So that is external work done to bring unit positive charge to this point, that is potential at this point. I suggest that you should go back to your textbook and again revisit that potential definition and try to understand what is basically saying. It is basically saying that work done required to bring unit positive charge from infinity to at a point in the electric field, that is the potential for that point. So that is why that Vr is the work done by external agent to bring unit positive charge to this point. So that is our potential. I hope this point is clear. So let us come to our current problem in hand, that is our this problem. For this problem, what do we have to do? That basically we have to calculate the work done to bring Q charge to this point. So what we have to do? We have to calculate first the potential at this point. We have to calculate the potential at this point, say that is V naught. So V naught we have to calculate first, and if we calculate V naught, what will be the V naught for the origin? V naught, if we know the potential at the origin, this is actually our external work done to bring unit positive charge from infinity. So what will be the work done to bring this Q charge to our origin? So that will be W external, that will be the work done equal to Q into V0. It will be simple. So as V naught is our potential for the origin, it basically means that this is the work required to bring unit positive charge from infinity to this point. So if work done for unit positive charge is V 0 to bring Q charge from infinity to this point, that will be Q into V 0. So that will be our work done or external work done. So first we have to calculate V 0, that is the potential for this kind of charge distribution, and then we will just simply multiply that potential with Q 0 and this will be our answer. To calculate the V 0 at origin, we need to find these distances, because for this charge that distance is simply 2 and this is also simply 2, but for this charge and this charge we need to calculate those distances. So let us draw this hypotenuse. So this is the distance from the corner charges, and this distance is, this is 4 unit, and this is the magnitude of this part is 2. So this will be 2 square 4 square root. From Pythagoras we can say that this distance is like this, that is 16 plus 4 root 20. So for as these are, these lines are similar, this line also will be root 20. So what will be our V 0? So potential at V 0 is potential due to this charge at this point, that will be Q by 4 pi epsilon 0. This magnitude of this distance is 2, so this one plus for that charge by 4 pi epsilon 0, that is root 20, plus for this one also Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 root 20, and for this one Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 2, V 0 will be. So this part is the potential for this charge, which is 2 unit, at 2 unit distance from the origin. This part is the potential for this one, this is potential for this charge, and similarly this is the potential for this charge. So our V 0 will be 4 pi epsilon 0 1 plus 1 by root 5. So this is our potential at the origin due to this charge distribution, and we have to calculate the work done to bring another fifth charge, which is at infinity to this point. That work done, as we said earlier, that work done will be Q V 0. So our work done is, work done origin is equal to Q into V 0. So that is Q into, that is our V 0. So this will be Q square by 4 pi epsilon 0 1 plus 1 by root 5. So this is our work done. This is our work done to bring Q charge from infinity to a point at the origin. So this is our final answer, and I hope that you understand the whole problem. If there is some difficulty in understanding, you can always write in the comment section. I will try to answer that. That's it for today, and we will always come back with another problem in another day. Till then, bye bye.